Greetings of the day. My name is Lakshman Jajudia. In this video lecture of BCom 4CEP for Financial Accounting, we will go for the adjustment treatment of various important adjustment in banking company final accounts. So, in the earlier videos, we have seen the theoretical framework of banking companies. After that, we have seen pro forma B, that was related with the P&L account of banking company, and in the last video we have seen the pro forma or the format of balance sheet for banking companies. We have said that instead of following P format, we would be following horizontal format for the vertical format is not applicable for banking company, it is applicable for horizontal format. So we will follow the horizontal format in the banking company. That is what we have studied in the last video, and we have seen what is the format of banking company. When we say to the adjustment, we all know what are the various adjustment in final accounts we have done with the various adjustment. Almost all the effects of adjustment is similar, but what is the change is about the schedules. We have seen that there are 16 schedules for banking company. For liabilities, there are 5 schedules. For assets, there are 6 schedules. For contingent liability, there is 1 schedule. For income, we have again 2 schedules. For expenditure, again we have 2 schedules. This is what is the schedule formation in banking company, and that is why we have to see the certain important adjustment effect so that we could understand in which schedule we have to get the particular entry of the adjustment. When we speak of adjustment, very first thing should came in our mind when we say about banking company is about the adjustment of statutory reserve, whether it is given or not given in the adjustment. It is written or not, it is your mandatory duty as an commerce student for fourth semester that you should put 25% of current year net profit in statutory reserve compulsorily. Diya hai, nahi diya hai, don't care. 25% statutory reserve mein jana hi chahiye, aapko ye hamesha yaad rakhna padega. If it is not so, then again whatever you have solved, whether your balance sheet is tallied or not, balanced or not, it would not be considered correct solution and you would not get your marks. Though we are saying that the exam can happen in MCQ pattern, it can also happen in the regular pattern in writing you all 16 mark questions. So possibility are on the both ends. Even if in the MCQ, we have to remember that statutory reserve is the reserve which is compulsory to be created on the 25%, or we can even say 1/4 of your current year net profit. जितना भी net profit रहेगा उसका 1/4 बिना सोचे हमको statutory reserve में transfer करना है, current year net profit. That is what is the criteria. So very first effect, P&L account में appropriation section, that was the section number 4. We have seen first section we have created for in P&L account income. Second section was for expenditure. Third section was for first for income. Second was for expenses. Third was for profit or loss. And fourth was for appropriation. Entries. This is what we have seen in our P&L account. So this is what we have to follow. As reserve is a part of appropriation, it would go in the fourth part of your P&L account, appropriation, and in balance sheet it will go to schedule 2, which says of reserves and surplus. There we have to add it in reserves column. For say if earlier reserves are been given there, we have to add in it. How we have to add in it? I would just show you here in a short way. For example, earlier statutory reserve opening balance, suppose this is plus current year transfer, this, then we would get our total. This is how we have to transfer our statutory reserve in the balance sheet. Similar kind of adjustment is for the other reserves also. For other reserve also, there should be criteria ki adjustment should be provided for other reserve. For example, it can be general reserve or DIF or any other reserve, regardless of statutory reserve, that should be included there in the P&L appropriation account. First of all, again in the schedule number 4, and again in the balance sheet also, it should be in the part of schedule 2 reserves. Again, how we would do it? For example, if reserve is given for particular, opening balance is given, then we would write opening balance plus current year transfer. We would make the total, and again this is how we have to get to the transfer to other reserves. First entry would be in the P&L account, part 4, that is for appropriation. In second, balance sheet, schedule 2, reserves and surplus. There we have to add it, and this is how we are to go it, we are going to write it in the schedules for the calculation of exact balance. This was both for the reserve. Now we will move to the RDD, that is reserve for doubtful debt. In case of bank, bank usually gives services, service of accepting deposit and giving loans. So here, what would be the doubtful debt? It would be loans and advances. So provide for RDD if adjustment is given. First entry would be again in the P&L account, it would go. P&L account mein kahan jayengi? Schedule 2, that is of expenditure. Expenditure, it would be going to the third part. First, we have said what we can say, interest paid. Second, we have said other expenses, operating expenses. And third one, we have said that provisions and contingencies. So it would go in the part second in third number, that is provisions. First of all, there we have to add it. Then it would go in balance sheet. बैलेंस शीट में हमको क्या करना है, शेड्यूल 9 जो है हमारा एडवांसेस का, उसमें फॉर एग्जांपल टर्म लोन है, टर्म लोन में से माइनस करना है आरडीडी. वी हैव टू गेट इट डिडक्टेड फ्रॉम टर्म लोन्स, देन ओनली आफ्टर वी वुड मेक प्रॉपर एडजस्टमेंट. और जो फाइनल अमाउंट आएगा दैट वुड बी ट्रांसफर इन दी बैलेंस शीट. सो वी हैव टू डिडक्ट इट फ्रॉम एडवांसेस, क्योंकि आरडीडी, व्हाट इज आरडीडी? आरडीडी इज कि वो पैसा हमारा डूब चुका है, हमको वापिस नहीं मिलेगा. So that is what we are doing. Suppose that you have given a loan of rupees 50 lakh as in bank to a XYZ customer, and the customer fails to repay the amount of rupees 5 lakh. At that time, that 5 lakh would be transferred to RDD, or isiliye aapko loan and advances mein se 5 lakh minus karne padenge, because you are not able to recover that amount. That is what, that is why it would be deducted from your advances. It may be term loan or any other loan. Now moving to the fourth adjustment, that would be of depreciation, a well known term to all of us. So in depreciation we would say ki what adjustment we have to make. First of all, first adjustment, schedule number 16, P&L account, clearly other operating expenses for banking company. So schedule number 16 we would add it up. And second expenditure, that is quite important. Here we have to do the second work quite, we can say that, we have to do the second adjustment quite tricky hai, thoda sa dhyan dijiye. In second adjustment, again we have to move to our balance sheet. Balance sheet, there can be two techniques for what we can say, doing the adjustment of depreciation. यहां पे ख्याल दीजिएगा, दो टेक्निक हो सकते हैं डेप्रिसिएशन इन बैलेंस शीट में ट्रीट करने के. फर्स्ट टेक्निक, इट वुड बी शेड्यूल 10, फिक्स असेट का जो हमारा होता है, वेयर वी वुड डिडक्ट डेप्रिसिएशन डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम असेट. हमारे जो असेट है उसकी वैल्यू में से हम डेप्रिसिएशन माइनस कर लेंगे और हमारा नेट असेट का वैल्यू निकाल लेंगे. That is what the first technique can be. We have taken into the schedule number 10 and we have deducted the value of depreciation from that particular asset. And we would get our now present value of that particular asset. That is first technique. Second can be, if depreciation fund is given, in case you have been given the depreciation fund in the trial balance, at that point of time, what we have to do in schedule 2, that would be of reserves and surplus. Depreciation fund is again a type of fund which is created for the purpose of depreciation. So it would be in the schedule 2. Again, what we have to do, we have to take opening balance plus total depreciation of particular assets. We would get it total and that amount would be written in liabilities. Schedule 2 is for liabilities, whereas fixed asset was for assets part. So difference kya hai, agar depreciation fund diya to liabilities ke andar adjustment karna hai. Agar depreciation fund nahi diya, then we will move to schedule 10 of asset. Wahan pe particular asset mein se we would deduct that part of depreciation from that particular asset. So here we have to be careful while performing the adjustment of depreciation for fixed assets. Then proposed dividend. Suppose that bank has declared the dividend, then in that case first entry would be in the P&L appropriation account, again fourth part in our P&L account, whereas second entry will move to the balance sheet. In balance sheet it can move where? It can move in schedule number 5 of other liabilities. There we have to add it in other liabilities. Proposed depreciation by that head, very simple. Then provide for income tax. When we say about income tax is for the provision. So in P&L account it would go into the provisions part, that is in the expenses third part. Matlab P&L account, in P&L account we would write expenses, and in expenses we would write provision for income tax in provisions, and second part would again will be in the balance sheet, that is other liabilities. We have to add for the provision for income tax in other liabilities. Then last one would be for provide for rebate on bill discounted. When we say about bill discounted, it means that bank, we have studied in the earlier years that bank usually discounts the bill for their customers and gives them immediate payment. In that discount is income for that bank, and in that income usually bank provides for rebate, that it gives an additional benefit to its customer. That is why it is a part of discount for the bank also, ki bank ne apne customer ko bill discount karne pe jo rebate diya, jo chhoot di hai, usko yahan pe humko treat karna hai. Very first effect, it would be deducted in schedule number 13, that is in from interest income, because bank is sacrificing its income by giving rebate to their customers. So from P&L account schedule number 13, that is income from interest, we have to deduct it. Second part, it would go in the other liabilities part, because bank has only provided for, because provision is there, that is why it would go in the balance sheet part of other liabilities, that is schedule number 5. This was with related to your adjustment, first effect and second effect. Before sum upping our lecture, we have to clearly remember one thing is about our schedules. For schedules, we have to keep one thing in mind, that we have to remember what are the various number and names of schedule and where they are going to be. For example, if I would say schedule 16 are there, and for that purpose we need to remember each and every schedule. That is why it is important to remember in the particular sense or particular manner. So when we speak of schedule, we have to remember all the number and exact name of that schedule. We have said that for liabilities we have 5 schedules, for assets we have 6 schedules, for contingent liability we have 1 schedule, for income and expenditure we have 2 schedules respectively. So for liabilities, what are our schedules? We can remember it by picking the initials of it. Schedule 1, C for capital. Schedule 2, R for reserves and surplus. Schedule 3, for deposits, schedule 4 for borrowing from other banks, schedule 5 for other liabilities. Similarly, when we speak of assets, we would again pick the initials of each schedule. Schedule 6, cash. Schedule 6, cash and balance with RBI. Schedule 7, bank balance with other banks. Schedule 8, investment. Schedule 9, loans and advances. Schedule 10, fixed asset. Schedule 11, other asset. Simple, straight pattern. Capital, reserves, deposit, borrowing, other liabilities, cash, bank, investment, advances, fixed assets, other assets. Similarly, for contingent liability, we have our schedule number 12. We have schedule number 12 for contingent liability. We can take it. When we move to income, the pattern, income and expenditure for P&L account, the pattern is simple. IO, interest, others. For income, schedule number 13, interest received, 14, other income. For expenditure, schedule number 15, interest paid, schedule number 16, other operating expenses. In a simple manner, we can remember all the names of these schedules along with their respective numbers in that easy manner. So, technique is CRDBO, CBI, AFO, IO. We can split it CR, DBO. CR for credit, DBO, you can remember it. Then CBI, AFO, then IO. It would be quite simple to remember in this manner the name and number of schedule. Otherwise, we have to recite it, we have to learn it, or else we can practice it so much that automatically we will have the print of the number of schedule in our mind. This is it for this lecture. In the next lecture, we will start with our practical question and answer for banking company final account. Until then, stay tuned. Thank you.